Hey there, Jason Schappert here of MzeroA.com, and I want to take a moment to share with you the importance of understanding and utilizing ATC traffic advisories. What am I talking about first off? Well, let me give you an example of what we'll call a basic traffic advisory.
November 23 Mike Zulu, traffic 12 o'clock, 5 miles eastbound. Altitude indicates 3,500.
Negative contact, 23 Mike Zulu. All right, 12 o'clock, 5 miles. So looking for that, and 3,000, we're at 2,500 right now. Remember, it works like a clock. So 12 o'clock is right in front of us. If you look, we have a simulation here to show you kind of top down so you can see all of that. 12 o'clock's right in front of us, but remember that that is based off of our ground track, right?
You see, when the FAA issues a traffic advisory, they issue to it on a clock basis. So in our example, it was at 12 o'clock. But you have to realize that that is based on our ground track. Just because the air traffic controller said 12 o'clock doesn't mean it's right out in front of us. What if I have a strong left crosswind and I'm actually, maybe I'm 10 or 20 degrees to my left? 12 o'clock might be more like 10 o'clock for 23 Mike Zulu in this case, yet my ground track remains going straight ahead, as you can see there. Remember, when controllers are giving you traffic advisories, it's based off of your ground track. So keep that in mind when they tell you traffic 10 o'clock or traffic 12 o'clock, to maybe glance down and look at where the winds are coming from, or with situational awareness, perhaps we know where the winds are coming from as well, and understand it might be a little bit of a window because it's based on your ground track. Now, controllers also issue something else called a safety alert. Let's go ahead and listen to what a safety alert sounds like.
Traffic alert, November 23 Mike Zulu, traffic 12 o'clock, 2 miles eastbound, altitude indicates 2,500, turn left heading 230 immediately.
Left 230 immediately, 23 Mike Zulu. Left turn 230 immediately, and making my turn while watching for that traffic as well.
So as you can see, a safety alert is something immediate. Suggest this heading, or immediate left turn here, immediate climb, immediate descent. There is a true safety issue, and if one of us doesn't make an adjustment, it could have a very bad outcome. So it's important that when we hear a safety alert, that again, we are still the pilot in command, right? CFR 91.3, I have the final authority as the safety of this flight. But if I'm able to make that immediate left-hand turn and I'm not in IFR conditions, that's going to add to spatial disorientation or anything else along these lines, I'm going to do my best, still within my PIC responsibility, to make that left turn with that. So I hope you learned a lot about traffic advisories and safety alerts and understand the whole clock system just a little bit better. I wrote the Private Pilot Blueprint with the intention of, if I could do my flight training over, would I wish someone would have told me? And I want that book to be yours for free. All I ask is that you pay shipping. Visit privatepilotblueprint.com to get your free copy.